What the heck is up, you guys? It's your boy Ace, aka Animated Heroes, here back with another action figure review. Today we're going to be taking a look at the new Batman Adventures Batman from Mafex or Medicom Toys. Let's go ahead and get into it. Now, starting off with that sexy packaging, you can see the figure through the window right there, looking really freaking good, by the way. You have the DC logo right there, an image of Batman right there. It says the new Batman Adventures right there, Batman action figure, Mafex, Medicom toy. At the top, it just says the new Batman Adventures, all the legal stuff on the bottom, full image of him on the side with pretty much the same stuff I've already announced. This is number 137. We've got an image of him gliding in right here, once again looking really freaking good. And then on the back, we do have some more poses we can get the figure into, as well as, I guess, some more legal stuff and Medicom's website. But let's go ahead and bust this figure open because this is one that I have been waiting on. First impression of this guy right out of the packaging, I gotta say, this thing is fudging awesome, man. This, for those of you who don't know, Batman is my childhood. Batman is my everything when it comes to superheroes. Like, Batman is who I aspired to be as a kid. Batman is just that superhero that gave me that comfort, that gave me that joy, that made me feel like I could be anything that I wanted to. Like, a lot of people don't know this about me, but Batman is my favorite hero. And I think I've expressed that enough. But this right here is not just Batman. This is my entire childhood wrapped into a figure made by my favorite action figure company. And it's so difficult for me to express how happy I am with this. Now, I know a lot of people wish that this was Batman from the animated series. But guys, you got to realize, Mafex is still out there showing us what they are capable of, meaning that that's a figure that could be in the works. Who knows? Within the next year or so, they could possibly make that version of Batman, because no one was expecting this when they announced it. No one was. I don't care who you are. You can't tell me you were expecting this. And now just having this already makes me want Joker. And it really makes me wish that I kept my Batman the Animated Series stuff from DC Collectibles. But a lot of that stuff just ended up breaking. And so I was like, I want to pose these too much. They can't pose. I got to get rid of them, because otherwise I just wasted money. So I just sold them to someone who wanted to sit them on their shelf. But anyway, back to this figure, man. This is awesome, man. This is so awesome. You have that kind of just neutral Batman expressions. The dimensions on this are proportions, rather. They're accurate to the series. And on top of that, they still integrated all the articulation that they normally do. This is just so amazing, man. And it's very plain. There's not much they really could have done with it, but the sculpt work is there. You have this really wide torso with the narrow frame as it goes down to the waist, and then the slender legs. And yeah, it looks like Batman skipped leg day, but this is exactly how it was in the cartoon. And then you even have the feet that are just simply sculpted, and they look so good, man. And I thought that the DC Collectibles, when it came out, was just extravagant. But this right here has completely blown my mind. I love this so much. The paintwork, there's not a whole lot of it. It's just gray, black. You have, of course, the skin tone right there and the yellow on the belt. I feel like the belt could have been a little bit more yellow just to kind of pop a bit more, but still, that's not bad at all. Other than that, man, there's not much to it. You got the wired cape here. This is awesome, man. I really love this. But anyway, let's go ahead and put him back, because I talked a little bit more than I planned to, so we can see how tall that this guy stands. Now, in terms of the height on this guy, to the top of his bat ear, he stands a little bit over 6.5 inches. So pretty tall figure. Of course, he's still going to fit in scale with your 6-inch figures, but he's taller than I thought he was going to be. And I can't complain about that. That makes me happy. Batman is a tall character. So yeah. Moving right along to the articulation, Batman doesn't really look up much, and obviously, as you can see, the back of his head is touching the back of the neck, so that's about as much as you're going to get out of that. He really doesn't look down either. As you can see, the chin is touching the neck, But the problem is just that the neck is real thick and so is the face. And so it still just kind of looks like he's looking forward if you pose it that way. That being said, he does get really good tilt and turn, so you can get pretty expressive with this Batman. Now, one thing that I love is the engineering they did for the arms, because at first glance, it looks like it's going to be bare minimum, but you can get his arms to go up and out about that much, and this is where it gets really impressive. He actually has, and I'm going to have to turn it, but he actually has a butterfly joint. That is freaking awesome. Like, because the chest is so wide, you would think that he doesn't have it because you can't even see that it's there. Normally, you'll see like some lines cut in the side, but you don't see these at all. It just kind of works. And so when you bring it forward, let's say you have a Batmobile and you want to put him in the Batmobile, have him driving. You can do that. Or if he's punching forward, yada, 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 whatever you want to use it for. Now, one thing I will say, this was an issue I had that I recommend you guys, if you experience it, take care of it early. It's these the bicep swivel. And this is something that I already experienced with a Batman figure earlier this year. It broke. And I think that was my fault because I was playing with it too much. But on this one, this one side right here was pretty stiff. And so I would make sure if it feels stiff, if you hear squeaking or anything like that, put it in hot water, take it apart, oil it immediately. Don't wait, because these are a very fragile plastic and these things will break. Now, I will go ahead and give you the heads up. It is a pain to take this guy apart because of how fragile the plastic is, and because of the fact that I already broke a Batman this year, I was trying to be extremely careful with it, and it was a pain to put it back together. So just be aware of that. Just take your time, be patient, don't get frustrated with it, and if you have to step away from the figure for a bit, step away from the figure, but it's not worth breaking. So take your time, put it back together, and then you're good to go. But as far as the elbows go, he does have a double jointed elbow, so he can bring those fists in. He can almost touch the back of his head if you want him to. Now, as far as the hands go, they are on the typical hinge, and you don't have very much limitation because of the way that the gloves are sculpted. So that is awesome. Now, when you move this back out of the way, at the diaphragm joint, he leans back only about that much. He leans forward, not so much at all. You do get a lot of rocker in there. Now, most of the movement that you get at the torso is going to come out of the waist. And so if you utilize that waist, as you can see, he leans back pretty far. He still doesn't lean forward very much, but you can get him to lean a tad. So there you go for that. Of course, he does have waist turn. Now, as far as the legs go, this is kind of like those old DC figures that had the Y joint. And so it's on the drop down leg method. But when you pull it forward, the leg kind of like curves out. And that's to be expected with this figure because he has this small crotch piece right here, these thin legs. Everything up here is thick, and then it gets like smaller once you get to the lower half. And so with the way that all this is sculpted, that's kind of to be expected. But yeah, like I said, he does have a thigh swivel, double jointed knees. The foot goes down about that much, up about that much. He does get ankle rocker. You kind of got to watch this joint right here because of how slim it is. You don't want to try to force it. You got to work your way around that joint to make that articulation possible. So be careful with that. And then as far as the foot goes, he does have a toe hinge as well. So yeah, articulation wise, with this design and what they had to work with, I think it's pretty exceptional. I will just say, in the smaller pieces, make sure that you're careful because those are going to be more fragile on a figure like this. Moving on to accessories, you don't get a whole lot with this guy, but I still think you get a fairly decent amount. Honestly, there's only one thing that I could think of to add, and I'll discuss that later. First off, you do get a pair of fist hands, and then you get the neutral expression for Batman. That's pretty much standard for him. You get a pair of wide open palm hands, so like he's reaching, grabbing, I don't know, touching a wall or something. You get a pair of these, I don't know what to call these. They're the grapple hook holding hands, but I don't know what you would call them. These are very nicely sculpted. They're simple, but well done. And then this is the grapple right here. As you know, you just kind of slide that between the fingers, and then that is how that goes. I love that. That is dope. Since I've got the grapple out and I'm showing it, you do get this piece right here that plugs into the grapple. Now, this is not meant to be bent at all. You just plug it right here in the front of that, and that's how that's supposed to look. That is dope. I love the claw on that and everything. I wish they would have gave us a wired one, but I still can't complain. So yeah, that is dope. As far as other hands go, you get a pair of relaxed type hands. So these can be for when he has his hands down by his side or whatever you want to use them for. And then you get a pair of Batarang holding hands. Normally we'll get two or three Batarangs, but this time around they only gave us one. So if you have some of the other Batman figures, and I didn't mean to hit the camera, but if you have some of the other Batman figures they've released, you will get more. But it's just this simple Batarang right here, and I'll show you guys how that looks in hand. You kind of just plug that right in there, and I don't know, there's not a specific way that it goes. You just kind of sit it in there for the most part. I don't really like how that is. I wish they would have worked around that, like put a slot where you can plug this in there. But yeah, you can, there's a way he can hold it. Let me see, there we go. Maybe you have to do it like this, I don't know. Yeah, he doesn't want to hold it. I'm gonna look on the box and see, and then we'll go from there. So yeah, the box shows it just how I had it in hand, and for whatever reason, he doesn't want to hold it. I don't know, maybe I'm doing it wrong, but yeah, anyway, he's not, well, it'll hold right there, but it's not, okay, yeah, it's not going to stick, but he does hold the battery. Anyway, I'm not going to spend forever talking about that. He does come with an alternate cape, and this is just for when he has it just flowing down his back, and it's pretty easy to put on. I'm actually going to show that because I want to. You just pop the head off, and then if you want to have Batman where he doesn't have his cape on, you can, but the neck is going to look super long because of how high the head sits up. So for those of you who are planning on recreating that, this is what you're going to get if you do that. Now, if you put the cape on, this is how it is going to look. That looks pretty sick in my opinion. I like that a lot, especially how it sits over the shoulders, the way that he actually used to wear it quite often in the series. So in terms of accessories, that's pretty much all you get, and I'll say I'm fine with that. This looks good. He comes with a decent amount. I do wish that he came with like a teeth gritted face. I feel like that would have been the cherry on top, but who knows, sometimes they will add accessories to other figures, so maybe one day they'll release, I don't know, Riddler or something, and then we'll get a teeth gritted face for this Batman. So you never really know. But yeah, anyway, let's go ahead and get into those size comparisons. Moving on to size comparisons, here he is standing next to a couple of Batman figures that I have. I still don't know which one this is. It's some Mattel release, I'm sure, but I picked it up at a convention at some point for like $15, and I just wanted it because it's Batman. But anyway, we also have him standing next to the New 52 Greg Capullo Batman, and then the Mafex Dark Knight Returns Batman, or Old Man Batman, whichever one you want to call him. Now, if you're like me and you're trying to figure out who you want to pose this guy in photos with, if you do shoot pictures of your figures, here he is standing next to a DC Icons Harley Quinn, a Mafex Superman. This is the Superman from Hush. I almost forgot which this was from. And then we do have the DC Icons Nightwing. I don't think these look too well with him just because of the art style. I think you could make Harley Quinn work, but the rest of them, absolute no-go. But it would be dope if they made an animated style Superman. And since they're releasing a Dark Knight Returns Superman, I think it's possible. Here he is standing next to the Mafex or Medicom Toys Batman Hush, who his cape lately has been driving me insane. At first I was able to deal with it, but now I absolutely hate this thing, but I love the figure. Anyway, a DC Icons Batgirl. This is the one that came with the motorcycle, which is such a great figure, and then the Hasbro G.I. Joe Cobra Infantry. And lastly, a few extra figures that I think that he would work well in photos with. We do have the Batman Beyond McFarlane Sheik or Shriek. I don't remember what it is. I think the art style between these is similar enough that you can get these two in photos and they'll look fine. This is the Jazzwares Fortnite 8 Ball, which I think also looks well with him. And then, of course, we do have the Hasbro Chaos Agent from Fortnite also. So I think these are some figures that would look cool in photos with him. So you'll probably see them in shots at the end of the video. Now overall, this is a figure that naturally I was going to be impressed with simply because of the fact that it is the new Batman Adventures Batman. And anything that is a cartoon Batman, I have to pick up. It's just pretty much at this point mandatory for me just because of how much I love Batman. And I'm pretty sure I expressed that enough at the beginning of the video, but this thing is just awesome. I know there's going to be a lot of people who are going to sit this one out and probably wait for the animated series version Batman, which I do hope that they make. But at the same time, I do hope that they make a few more characters from this line. I would really love Tim Drake Robin. I would love Dick Grayson Nightwing, Batgirl. There are some designs I hope that they stay away from. Like Catwoman, they can keep that. Her outfit was trash to me. Scarecrow would be dope. I know a lot of people didn't like that Scarecrow, but I really loved it. The Joker, I ain't care for that one that much, but I mean, hey, he's already up for pre-order, so I want to pick it up just because I got this guy. This figure has made me decide to pick up that Joker just because this thing is really freaking cool in my opinion. And at this point, I don't see us getting a better version of this figure. McFarlane's not going to deliver it. There's no way in hell they will do as good as this. DC Collectibles, they put out some cool figures, but those just didn't work for me because I like to pose my figures. And I think those were more meant to stand still. So, yeah, but this is just an awesome figure, man. I can understand why some people wouldn't want to spend $80-$90 on it, though. So if it's one you're going to pass on, by all means. But if you are planning on getting it, pick it up. You can always resell it and get your money back if it's not for you. I love this thing a lot. So anyway, that being said, that's my review. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If so, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. That always helps me out. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and make sure to hit that bell icon to be notified whenever I upload new content. Lastly, follow me on everything you see listed in the description below to keep up with my activity outside of YouTube. I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Stay safe wherever you are, and bye.